consider.
All right, and our viewers probably just heard what we heard from Shimon, saying the indictments are out. Shimon, we're going to give you a moment to read through them. You let us know when you are ready.
I mean, I can read some of the stuff. At least
okay.
This has now just been released by the press office of the special counsel, so just bear with me here. But here's basically the first line. It says, Paul Manafort, 68, of Alexandria, Virginia, and Richard Gates, 45, of Richmond, Virginia, have been indicted by a federal grand jury on October 27th in the District of Columbia. The indictment, it goes on to say, contains 12 counts: conspiracy against the United States, conspiracy to launder money, unregistered agent of a foreign principal, false and misleading FARA statements, false statements, and 7 counts of failure to file reports of foreign bank and financial accounts. So there we now know, we have some idea at least of what the charges are, and a lot of it is what we've been talking about, that it's going to have to deal with financial crimes. Paul Manafort's work and now Rick Gates' work overseas with Ukraine and possibly other countries, and this is what we've been reporting for some time now, that this is where the focus of some of the special counsel's investigation has been.
All right, Shimon, thank you. And Susan, let's bring you in. Let's just explain to people who Rick Gates is. A lot of people know who Paul Manafort is because he chaired the president's campaign. Rick Gates is someone, a political consultant, who has been by Manafort's side for decades, who worked along with him, you know, on the Trump campaign, even beyond Paul Manafort. When Paul Manafort stepped down, Rick Gates, Susan, as you know, kept working with the president on the inaugural committee and then raising $25 million for a big PAC that supports the president until April, when he was ousted because of concerns on these Ukraine dealings. What are your thoughts this morning?
So one of the things we've seen sort of as the president's tactics in the past is whenever bad news has come out about individuals sort of related to him, he really tries to distance himself pretty quickly, right? They weren't a big part of the team. Steve Bannon came on very late. So what's going to be relevant here is, of course, how strongly they try and distance themselves from Paul Manafort. That's going to be difficult considering his prominent role in the campaign. And then how do they try and distance themselves from Rick Gates? What's going to be hard about Rick Gates, as you mentioned, is that he actually stayed on, was part of the inaugural committee. And so that's going to make it far more challenging for the Trump team to say, hey, look, we didn't know anything about any of the suspicions around these people. As soon as we found out they were sort of bit players, we pushed them out, and right, their behavior doesn't reflect on us and doesn't reflect on our judgment.
Jeffrey, when Shimon was reading the 12 counts, the first one was conspiracy against the United States. Shimon, was that accurate? Because we're just piecing through this document right now.
Yeah, that is accurate, and that's what the press release said. I now have a copy of the indictment, so I'm going through it to see exactly what that means, but Jeffrey may have a better idea.
So am I. It relates to tax offenses,
okay.
Among other things. But, I mean, I think what's striking initially, first of all, you know, this is a 31-page indictment. That's a very long indictment. Indictments are often much shorter than this. And it deals with financial dealings primarily, but not exclusively. And I think it mostly deals with Manafort and Gates' personal finances, money laundering, using the money they got from the Ukraine to hide it from the tax authorities, not to report it properly. So that's my initial impression, but I have to admit I'm still just going through it, and I haven't gotten to the end. It's long.
So a few things here. Susan, you know, Jeffrey rightly brings up Ukraine, and we know that Manafort and Gates worked for Ukraine for about a decade. Worked for Viktor Yanukovych's government, obviously, friendly with the Putin regime until he was ousted a few years ago. Remember in the last year or so, a handwritten ledger was found with over $12 million in payments that was supposedly from the Yanukovych regime to Manafort. Now, Manafort said that was all made up. Now, why is this tied to this? Maybe, well, Evan Perez was reporting earlier that 2010, that tax year, when he was also working for the Ukrainian government, is of key interest to investigators right now.
Right, so one of the things that's sort of important to keep in mind, even once we've seen the indictment, is the nature of what a tax charge might mean. So the government often uses tax charges as a way to indict someone. And so it could be that they're indicting Paul Manafort for failure to pay income on failure to pay taxes on legitimate income, right? So sort of there's nothing wrong with the original source of the income and he didn't pay taxes, and that's where the criminal activity comes in. It's also possible that the government is using tax or fraud charges in order to go after illegal illegitimate sources of income. So perhaps it's too difficult to prove sort of the more complex money laundering or other charges related to where the source of that income might have been. So instead they say, look, we have reason to believe you have this illicit income. We know that you didn't pay taxes and that we can prove that element of it. And so they start there. So even though we're starting to get sort of the first concrete information in this indictment, there's still a lot of open questions related to what is the underlying conduct here, and really, you know, the full scope of that 31 pages, and then information that's going to trickle out over the next sort of days and weeks and hours.
Let me read you something from page one right now, and there are 31, and we're piecing through it right now. Manafort and Gates generated tens of millions of dollars in income as a result of the Ukraine work in order to hide Ukraine payments from United States authorities from approximately 2006 through at least 2016. So this went up through the election year. Manafort and Gates laundered the money through scores of U.S. and foreign corporations, partnerships, and bank accounts. Again, Jeffrey, we'll keep on reading through this. Go ahead.
But I think a very significant point, two points. One, the Trump campaign is not mentioned in this indictment. I have gone through it once. And that's, I think, a very important point. It is certainly something you will hear from the president's supporters, and I think it's a very valid point. It does not include any reference to his work on the Trump campaign. However, it also does include statements that he made during the time that he was the chair of the Trump campaign. So that, I think, is highly significant, that that Robert Mueller is alleging that that Paul Manafort was committing crimes while he was the campaign chairman of the Trump campaign.
And Jeffrey, again, it does not preclude the possibility that this 12-count indictment will not be used to try to get information about the Trump campaign.
Absolutely. And you know, one thing, you know, people need to know about the way prosecutions work is that just because an indictment has been filed doesn't mean that that's the only indictment to be filed. There's something called a superseding indictment where you can add charges against the same defendant. So we are not at the end of the process by any means.
And most experts would say really at the beginning. And the timing here, tomorrow, as Evan reported, the date runs up for some of these tax issues to be charged. That's tomorrow, the end of the month. So they had to get some of this out. So as you're saying, there could be more added to this.
There could be more added, but believe me, This is a bad day for Paul Manafort and Rick Gates, even if this is all the charges that they face. I mean, these are 12 very serious felonies with very heavy penalties associated with.